My Faber sets of return to the octagon against Ricky Simone, July 13th card in Sacramento. A little bit strange. Was not expecting that at all.
Yeah, definitely strange. I wasn't expecting it at all. Uriah Faber, great guy, by the way. And maybe we'll get him on the show. I think we had him on a long, long time ago. Uriah's we did, in fact. We had him on. Let's get him on again. We'll give him a call. We'll ask him his reasons. I'm sure they're out there in an interview somewhere. And I'm sure the generic answer is, he missed the competition, bro. You know, man, I'm in there, I'm training with these guys, you know, man, and I'm like kicking ass every day, and I'm just like, you know, man, I totally still got this, bro. I can, like, you know, hang 10 down the surfboard and shit, and I'm like, you know, bro, I can, like, totally kick ass, man, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, fuck you, why not get paid for this shit, homie, is what I was thinking, man. So, like, you know, I got a solid connect over at the UFC, man, so I was like, hey, bro, Dana hooked me with a contract, bro, and I'm like, you know, it is what it is, man. I mean, maybe I'll take a fight, I'll fight Ricky Simone. Maybe I'll take three fights, five fights. I'm just taking it one fight at a time, man. I don't know where I'm going with this. You know, I'm just like, I'm not planned out. I'm just living in the moment, man. I'm just smoking weed, getting high as fuck, and like doing my thing, bro. Just like totally rolling with it. Okay? I'm sure that's what he'll say.
So I was going down a hill on my longboard, drinking a Mountain Dew, and you know, and then I thought, you know, I just miss this life. I miss this life, man. Dude, your Uriah Faber impression is my favorite impression of yours. I had no idea you had a Uriah Faber just in you this whole fucking time. Years of broadcasting together.
Dude, like, what am I, like, totally doing with my life and shit right now? I'm like, oh, my God. Like, I got, like, all these guys around me, and they look up to me like a godfather, man. I got Cody Garbrandt in there, and he's, like, kind of lost right now, dude. He's, like, he doesn't know where he's going or anything, man. Like, this guy's lost three in a row. I got to prove to him I'm a warrior, okay? I'm a samurai, bro, okay? So I'm not totally going to do it. I'm going to show him that, like, we can build our way back and be an inspiration and shit, you know?
I love it. I would go follow Uriah Faber. Just fucking cool pothead, surfing, getting pussy, just finger banging chicks. But you know what? I don't know. I'm just like knee deep in pussy and money, but I just missed competition.
I like your Uriah Faber impression way better. Every time you do yours, I laugh my ass off. That's like a legitimate laugh. Rolling down on a longboard, drinking Mountain Dew. That is hilarious.
The wind's going through my hair, and I'm like, you know what, dude? I just miss competing.
It's like, man, you know, I know I got a Ferrari and shit and, like, whatever. But no. I was surprised because, by all accounts, Uriah Faber is a very, very successful businessman. And no disrespect, Uriah. We all, everybody loves the fucking California kid. Yeah, he's a very successful businessman. Has his fingers in a lot of pies, even dabbling into
fuck yeah, bro.
What's that?
Finger in a lot of pies, bro. I know what you mean. We all know what you mean.
Yeah, right, dude. So, you know, he's got his fingers in a lot of pies. He's even producing some movies these days, if I'm not mistaken. So he's keeping busy. He still has Team Alpha Male. They have this other new gym that they open, which is a beautiful facility as well. I probably think it's kind of what I said in jest in that stupid accent. I think it's probably a case of he's around the gym. He's working out with the guy still. He's the head coach. And he's like, hold on a minute. I've still fucking got this. I'm maybe dominating some of the guys in there.
Well, that has to be the thing, right? You start training with these guys. And you're like, this is a new young killer. You're like, oh, I'm kicking this guy's ass in the gym. It has to kind of get into your head. And you've talked about it before. Missing training for a fight. I can relate to that, dude. I'm fat as shit right now. And the motivation to even work out. You have movies, so I guess it's easy for you. You're trying to do things like related with that, and that has to keep you motivated, without a doubt. That, like, it gives you a reason to be in shape. If I have a vacation coming up, I always sort of get motivated, and I think there's that side of it too. You're like, fuck, dude, I don't have any goal, this really big goal, right, which is so finite as well, which is, it's right there, it's 3 months away, it's a very specific goal, you have to hit a weight, hitting that goal is a separate goal within the goal, winning the fight, all of those things fire off these things. Hitting goals is awesome, dude. If you ever just have a goal to organize your fucking, your dresser, and you finish it, you step back and you look, you're like, fuck, dude, I did it. It feels awesome. Anybody in the world knows what it feels like to accomplish something, to finish something. Yeah. And I think that right there, where I don't know how involved in all of his businesses are and closing his business deals, there, I think he probably misses just setting a goal and fucking hitting it and getting that deadline and feeling like you accomplished something.
Yeah, no, you know, thinking about this, and again, I'm not trying to put myself on a pedestal above any other fighter, but So I think there's got to be an element, and if I'm wrong, I apologize. And again, this just occurred to me. It's the thought that popped into my head. And as I apologized to my transgender friend, you know, I said, listen, things just pop in my head sometimes, and sometimes I take a shot in the dark and think it's funny. And sometimes it lands, sometimes it doesn't. This just occurred to me, and maybe I'm fucking wrong. But I think maybe it sounds logical to me, is that part of the thing as a fighter, of course, you love fighting, you love competing, you love mixed martial arts, you love the money. You know, and but by all accounts, I don't know his finance, you know, the state of his finances, but his financial affairs, from what I hear, are very good, you know, and rightly so. But there's one thing that money can't buy, and it's attention. You know what I mean? And you miss being the center of attention. You miss that thrill of the event being about you, you know, and being, well, the center of attention, and people selling tickets and going out there to fight and being the fucking man, in its simplest terms, being the man for one night, you know, and walking out in front of the crowd and 20,000 people cheering your name and willing you to win. Do you know what I mean? And the thrill and the rush of winning. Do you know what I mean? No drug could ever compare to it, you know. So it's got to be part, you know, that's going to be a massive part of it. It has to be.
Yeah, must. I mean, dude, it is, I mean, so much respect for what you guys do. We've talked about it a million times, my dumb fight. But I never played baseball or football or anything as a kid. I never scored the winning touchdown, right? I was never that kid. I was always the kid who was into music or into, like, I had weird interests growing up. It was never sports. It was never competition like that, right? And when I did that fight and I won, that feeling, I don't know there's no other way to describe it, okay? Except for it has to be what it feels like to win the winning touchdown, you know, and that feeling of, like, holy fucking shit. Like, it's like, it's unparalleled. There's not really anything you can compare it to. Whatever psychologically it sort of does for you, then you bring it to a level where you guys are very, very high level athletes who've been doing this career wise. That has to be an addiction. There's something about that that has to be like, fuck, dude. I mean, what am I going to do? What's going to fill that specific void for you, which is like all the things we've just kind of listed, right? There's nothing in the world. I don't care how many movie roles you get. It's never going to fill that specific void. And you have to, I guess, maybe a lot of fighters have a hard time coming to terms with that they don't necessarily need to fill that void. There's other things that they can do. And that's what you seem to have come to terms with.
Yeah. Well, for me personally, I mean, and my wife struggles with this sometimes. And my wife's amazing. She's supported me every step of the way. So don't get it twisted. That's not what I'm saying. But I spent a lot of time away from the family, you know, doing training camps, going for fights and all the rest of it. And now I'm retired. She probably would have liked it if I'm around the house a lot more. But now I'm away more than ever because I'm doing my UFC commentary. You know, I'm doing my UFC pre and post fight shows. I'm at most events. You know, I get back from being here in Africa. I'll be South Africa here for almost 4 weeks. I'll get back. I'm here for a day. I'm home, pardon me, for a day and a half. And then I fly to Chicago.
When are you home?
I'm home next Tuesday. Can't wait. Thursday evening, I fly out. So me like too. A day and a half, 2 days, I fly off to Chicago. Now, and I'm here doing this show, Warrior. And she's like, oh, babe, you know, please. And I'm like, but this is how now I'm getting my thrill. And I'm getting my chase, you know, and I'm working on something. I'm not just doing this for a little bit of money. I'm trying to build a second career.
Right.
I wanted to be a DJ. I succeeded in that. And then I wanted to be a fighter. I succeeded in that. Now I want to be an actor. And hopefully I'm going to succeed in that, you know. And I said to her, I said, give me 10 years. 10 years, I'll be 50 years old. And hopefully by then, we smash it. We make a fucking ton of money. And maybe we make a fraction of what Yoel Romero made in one night. And then we'll go buy a farm in the middle of fucking America somewhere, nice and cheap, a nice farm with some land in the woods, a river, have some horses, some chickens. That's our fucking dream. That's what we want to do. A nice, simple life.
Can I believe you?
Give me 10 years to chase it. Say again?
Can I be honest with you? I don't believe you will ever be able to stop working. Wherever you go, there you are. I love that phrase. I don't believe 10 years from now you're going to go, you know what? I'm no longer ambitious. I no longer want to create. I no longer want to.
No. Correct. You're right. That's what I'm sorry to interrupt you there.
No, it's okay.
But you're right. You are correct. But hopefully,
you'll be creating chicken eggs
by then. No. Hopefully by then, I'm in a position where I can literally just take because I want to work. All right, you're absolutely right. I recently had lunch with a director and an actor, right, about some movie projects. And we were talking about something, and I said, you know, we were talking about retiring, right? And I said, I could go. I said, no, I'd love it if I could go retire and lie on a beach for the rest of my life. Mm. I said, well, actually, I said, I probably could. I've got some money put away. I could probably go retire and live in a beach and do nothing. I said, it'd be a shitty beach in Mexico somewhere with a lot of litter and plastic.
Well, doesn't
on
that
it.
What said, Rebecca's parents do?
I could probably do it. And the director turned around and he said, but would you want to? I was like, no, what the fuck? I don't want to. But what I'm saying is hopefully in 10 years, my plan then is that I can just take projects that I'm passionate about and I want to do. You know what I mean? Two or three a year, something like that, or even one or two a year, and do that, you know, get my fill, and in between that, go home and be on the farm, Lewis.
If you have not already, hit that subscribe button with its notification bell and leave a comment in the comment box below of what you thought of the video, and tune in for more on MMA News Outlet.